I've got 16 kids.
I've got 16 kids.
And the poor husband.
I bet you you don't. I am well known in Australia because I am a mum of 16 children. Definitely one of the biggest families in Australia, and definitely probably one of the biggest where there's one mum, one dad, and all the children are ours. It is not something I planned on doing, having this many children, but it's everything that I needed in my life. Okay, so we've got 9 boys and 7 girls. Their names are Jesse, Brooke, Claire, Natalie, Carl, Samuel, Cameron, Sabrina, Tim, Brandon, Eve, Nate, Rachel, Eric, Damien, and the littlest one is Caitlin. And yep, the oldest is 32 and our youngest is 7. One moment you're dealing with older children and life decisions, jobs, relationships, money. Then we come through and we've got little kids. So, you know, we're still playing with toys and talking about birthday parties and cartoons on TV. And now that the grandchildren are coming through as well, the generational boundaries, those lines are all blurred because our youngest is only a couple of years older than our grandchildren now. So who calls who auntie and uncle or not? It's kind of all these little questions. Who's buying for who with presents for birthdays? It's such a blurred area now for us, and we never thought of that when we had our family. My husband Ray, we've been married now for 33 years, and when we first met, I didn't want any children, and he wanted 4 or 6 children, and I thought that that was absolute madness. It was never going to happen. So when we first got together, we officially dated for 2 weeks before he proposed to me, and I said yes, and I agreed to have 1, maybe 2 children. And I just love being a mum so much that I asked for 3, and we just kept going from there. As we went along, I think I just gained my own confidence in being a mum. And I had a chat with Ray's grandmother once, and she was like, you know, I was having the, I'm so tired, I'm so busy with all these little babies, I don't know what I'm doing. And she just said, Jen, I wish I could go back and do it all again. You really need to appreciate where you are right now. And for some reason, that really resonated with me at the time. And I took that on board. And I think I just relaxed into the fact that this was my job, my calling. This was what I was meant to do. So I think when we first got married, you know, We have a very traditional marriage, I guess, where I'm a stay-at-home mum and hubby goes out and works very hard to support us and provide for us. So I think, you know, as soon as we were having our first baby, we realised that, you know, there's going to be some struggle as you go along with your finances. So we might as well jump straight in and buy a house, which is what we did. We only had a little 2-bedroom home, and then I think we were having baby number 6 before we extended the house to get some more bedrooms on there. So it was pretty squishy there for a while. And we got some extra bedrooms, and we used 7 rooms as bedrooms at one stage when most of the children were living at home. And at the moment, you know, there's 2 to a room. I think when you live with a lot of people in a small space, you do managed to learn how to get along with most personality types. I mean, you've got some that are very laid back and very quiet. You've got some that are always sort of in your face and wanting an adventure. And it's so diverse. But the good thing, I guess, the one great benefit about having so many kids in a house is that if they are arguing amongst each other, they can literally pick themselves up, go to another room. There's something else going on there. They can join in somewhere else. So they don't hold grudges for very long because you just kind of forget about what that problem was and move on and go and have fun with somebody else. So I like to get up nice and early and spend a little bit of time for myself before everybody else gets up. you know, I might do a little bit of journaling, or there's laundry to hang out every day. So just that quiet time where nobody's asking you to do anything for them and just hanging out the clothes actually is one of my favourite times of day. Well, we have 9 of the children living at home now. Some are working and we've got 7 still in school. So we're up early and then, yeah, hubby's off to work. Some kids are off to work. We're doing school run. We drive a 16-seater bus. I had to get a truck license to be able to drive it. And then the other kids drive as well. There was some, you know, week to week, how are we going to get by? And I guess, you know, we figured as the more children we had, the dearer it was going to get. There's nothing cheap about raising children. It takes a lot of sacrifice, and I think you've got to be very focused on where you're spending your money and decide what your priorities are. For us, it was our children's education and paying our bills. And I think just making those memories, it's worth every cent. It's worth cutting the budget somewhere else so that you can make memories with your family. Well, for many years, you know, it was just a day trip away because that's all we could afford. And I can remember, I think we got to about 7 children before we started taking a fairly regular sort of breakaway to the beach or something like that. And it took all year to save just for those few days away. Yeah, having a big family, I mean, there's never-ending hugs and loads of love, but there's also loads of challenges as well. But what has taken me by surprise, and I never gave it any thought as we were growing our family, is that you might have a problem with a teenager, and just as that teenager has grown enough that they sort of come out of that stage, the next ones are coming into it. So we never sort of, between hubby and I, we never kind of get out of those stages. So we've been dealing with teenagers for a couple of decades. And, you know, I never gave it much thought that, you know, these sort of stages through children's lives were never going to end for such a long time. Even when they're grown and they're out of the house, life still happens. So there are still problems to deal with and conversations to have. So I still get calls from the older children to find out they might want to discuss something about a job, or you know, I had a kid phone the other night and wanted to know a laundry tip. So, you know, being a parent never ends. Ray's a great dad. He's a very hands-on dad. As I said, he's the one who taught me to change nappies and to look after the babies in the first place. I like to think he does most of the learner driving, because that's scary to me, right? So I let him take care of most of that. He does a lot of the sports with the kids. So most of our family play touch football, and Ray has played since before I even met him. So he gets to now play in a team with all of his kids. So that's lovely to watch. Yeah, so over summer comp, how many children, Eve, would we have playing? 9? Yeah, he's had up to 9 children playing with him at the same time, so that's really exciting. I just stay at home and wash the jerseys, so that's my role in all of that. When the kids are going to birthday parties at friends' houses, or they need drop-offs and pick-ups and stuff like that, that's generally Ray's job, so he's quite hands-on. Well, we have 6 grandbabies, age 3 and under, and we have very exciting news. One of our kids is having another baby, and so we're going to have 7 grandbabies by the end of the year.
Strike that. In breaking news, we can report that the Bonell family is growing even bigger. Since recording this interview with us, Jeni has told us that she's found out she's going to have an 8th grandbaby by the end of the year.
Look, I love to babysit, and you know, you get to do all the fun stuff with grandchildren, and then you get to hand them back when you're tired, so it's really fun. And I think, you know, each of our children will have the right amount of children for them. Not as big as ours. I think everyone's made it very clear that nobody's sort of aiming to have a mega-sized family. And I'm not sure whether that's because we just gave them such a great childhood and they don't want to grow up, or they've seen the sacrifices that we've made along the way to have so many children. 15 of the 16 are close by, most in Toowoomba. And then we have one son who lives in Western Australia. So we don't get to see him very often, but we talk a lot. We have some very long FaceTime calls, and, you know, the time difference always makes it a bit interesting. I know that he will often phone, and I'm kind of like, I'm already in bed. I'm, you know, it's late here because we're 2 hours ahead. So, so when we used to try and get everyone together, we would make a lot of phone calls and send a lot of text messages out. Yeah, we've got a family group chat that everyone's part of, and we just put all our messages in there, and everyone can just, you know, we can get together and coordinate from there. Look, if it's during summertime, you can't go past an Aussie barbecue, which is probably the easiest thing to arrange for that many people. We had a barbecue recently, and we had all 31 family members here, and that's our immediate family. So, yeah, we just had a barbecue for that. That was the easiest way to manage it. When we started off being parents, we never had to deal with anything more than a television set as technology. And I can remember when the eldest boy got his first Game Boy, and it was a big deal. And it was, you know, we were like, oh, you can have 1 hour at this time. As we've gone along, because we're raising a full generation of children, the technology nowadays is part and parcel of everything. It's part of their schoolwork. So they're on laptops and phones and computers every day, all day. Which I find adds a whole other level to parenting. It's challenging, and, you know, it's extra stuff for the parents to watch and to monitor. And I think you just have to teach children what's on there, you know, learn the skills of willpower and how to say no, what to stay away from, and to control yourself with how long you're on it. And I mean, we have our difficulties like other parents with that as well. Yep, on our Facebook and Instagram, I get a lot of questions from parents, and I spend a lot of my late nights at the computer chatting with mums, or they might have an issue with one of their children, and, you know, they're just looking for a little bit of encouragement or support, and I'm happy to sit there and chat with them about it. My best advice, I guess, to parents is to realise that we are all unique, and, you know, our children, each child is going to react differently to different situations, and, you know, it's all about just talking with each other and making sure that the communication stays open. We, along the journey, we not only had the 16 children that we have here with us, we also lost 7 babies along the way as well. So I think that changes your heart too as you go along, and you just, you know, we haven't had any more since the last one, and that's very sad to us, but we're so grateful for all the children that we've already got. I'm hoping that the house will never be completely empty. I hope that there's always some little feet running through this home. Look, you know, we will probably spend time doing all those things that we've wanted to be doing over these years that we just haven't had the time to do. Yes, for somebody, as I said right back in the beginning, for somebody who didn't want any children, to end up being so abundantly blessed with 16 children is amazing, and it gives me so much joy. And I think whether it's your family and your family size, whether it's the career path that you choose or how you live your life, I think we all just have to just keep stepping forward with that. Sometimes we're going to do the right things, and sometimes we're going to make the right choices, and sometimes we have to make those choices right. And, you know, if you find the blessings in the small things in your life, you're going to be happy. So, you know, if you've got a job that you're not sure whether it's the right job for you, just put 100% of yourself into that job, and you'll soon know. There'll be an inner joy whether that's the right job for you or not. So it's the same with family. You know, if you have a couple of kids and you're not sure whether you should have another baby or not, I think you will never regret the babies that you will have. You might regret the ones that you don't.